can replay and you can decide upon that. Okay.
Yes,
so
sir.
let me introduce about myself. I am Srinivasa Tirunagari. I have a total of 33 plus years of experience. I'm a freelancer since 2012. I've been into training. I train consultants from USA and India as well. Also, I'm a corporate trainer. I'm a consultant trainer to Oracle Corporation and Microsoft and other major vendors, major clients. I teach Python to the employees of Microsoft for their various divisions. So, and before 2012, I was with Cognizant Technology Solutions, Hyderabad. So I have international experience also. I lived in USA, Boston for 7 years. And I relocated to India in 2005 and joined in Cognizant as a principal consultant ERP. And I came out of Cognizant in 2012 to pursue on my own. So I'm a freelancer. Like, I do projects on Python and Oracle databases. So I help people in their projects. So I have expertise in these areas like Python, Core Java, SQL, PLSQL, MySQL, Data, and Hadoop.
All right, sir.
So this is all about myself. So briefly, could you briefly tell about yourself, like what is your?
Well, I'm a commerce student. I'm studying chartered accountancy.
Okay.
With a concentration in finance.
Okay.
And I'm looking to, you know, gather a certain knowledge in areas of data science, computer, machine learning. And I'm looking at Python as a start.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good, good, good. So you have any prior programming knowledge or?
No, no.
Okay.
I've learned C, C++ to a certain extent, but that's it.
Okay, no problem. Yeah. So Python is a very simple language and prerequisite, I think you can start afresh. Even if you do not have knowledge in programming language, anybody can learn Python with ease. It is very simple and easy to learn.
Okay.
So today I will explain about various features of Python, how you can program and how it is simple, etc. We'll look into that. Okay. About Python program. And so Python is very rare language in the sense that it doesn't have data types. So you don't have to declare a variable which holds a particular data. So you don't require to declare the variables. First of all, that is a very rare language, and they are also.
But simple. Then, how do we create a structure without having certain variables that are defined?
So basically, it will automatically adjust itself. So, for example, I will just stop here, and I will go to. I will explain this. This is a good question, actually. Say, this is an integrated development environment. It is known as PyCharm. So it is useful to design the applications. It has an editor. This is an editor. And also you can write the program and execute here itself.
Okay.
Say, for example, x is equal to 10 and y is equal to, say, 20. And then z is equal to x multiplied by y. And print z. That's it. You want to multiply two numbers, or you want to calculate area of rectangle, for that matter. So this
absolutely.
Is so I click on this green button. It will display the result here, 2,200. This is the outcome of this. So x and y multiplied, you get the 200. So here x is a variable, and it holds data 10. That is a integer value. Integer or four numbers. So y is also 20. That is also integer. Now,
correct. So here we have defined x and y.
We have not defined actually. We are using the variable straight away. As you calculate in your high school mathematics, you normally write let x is equal to 10, let y is equal to 20. In the same fashion, you just write down. If you look at C language, you need to declare how many variables? Three variables you need to declare. So what is the type of x?
Okay.
Y, all that. So
I understand. Okay, so defining and declaration are different things. Isn't it?
Exactly.
Yeah.
So declare, you need not declare the variables.
You need not declare the variables. Okay. You have to obviously define it.
Yeah. You just assign the value and straight away you can use it. And also in the program, say for example, I want to assign a string value, say hello, for example. And y is equal to say world. Say simple example. And I will print the values of x and y. So the same x in the previous case, line number one, it is as we are assigning 10. In line number six, I am assigning a string value. This is possible in Python. So if I execute it, you will get the result, right? So 200 is multiplication of x and y. That is, right? And hello and world, just printing the values of x and y.
Okay.
So here, what is happening? The type of the variable, x takes a string value. Here, x takes an integer value. So how do you find out while running the program, you want to see what type of value it is holding. So we have a function called type function, type and the x. So it will...
Okay, so it's a number.
It is an integer basically. So in this
case, integer, right?
It is an integer. It prints integer. Similarly, I can get the print type of x. So what value it will print? Let us see. So here it will print integer. And here it will print string. So look at this. Because class string, this is the thing.
Yes.
And this is the integer. So basically, it adjusts itself automatically, internally. So this is known as dynamic typing. Automatically, it will adjust itself to take the data, whether it is a string data or integer data.
Okay.
So you can use variables as you wish. You don't have to bother about the declaration and memory usage, memory management, etc. You don't have to worry
about details.
Simply, you can focus on the solution to a problem rather than features of the programming language.
Okay. I understand. Yeah.
That is very simplified. Yeah. So. So this is the thing, very rare language. So, and it is very simple and powerful. Though it is very simple, and you can design various applications ranging from machine learning applications and data science applications, as well as big data environment. So it is very powerful and robust. And nowadays, for ethical hacking, people are using Python to design programs. So, and best part is it is very easy to learn and very simple, and you can concentrate on solution to a problem rather than focusing on the syntax and the structure of the program. If you look at the Java, it is very complex. They have a lot of features and they made it complicated, but in Python they removed all the complexities and it is very simple. Okay. Hello, you are there? Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
I think some network issues probably. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So from my side, it's okay. But okay. Anyway, let me know if you have any issues.
Yes, sir.
And it has high-level data structures as well, like arrays, lists, and hash tables. We call them as dictionaries. Hash tables are associative arrays. We call them as dictionaries in Python. So sets are also there. We have high-level data structures available in Python for various to design different applications. And it has simple and effective approach to object-oriented programming. This object-oriented programming has three main features. One is encapsulation, second one is polymorphism, and third one is inheritance. These are the three features of operating OOPS concept. So in inheritance, OOPS is like object-oriented programming.
Yes.
So it has these three features, and they simplified a lot in Python. So if you are familiar with objects and classes, There is a separate chapter on object and classes. We'll deal with in detail with examples. Okay. So if you
hello?
If you are aware of the
hello, yes sir.
If you
objects and classes.
Objects and classes, I will define briefly what is a class. Class is nothing but a blueprint or a plan. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So based upon the plan, you perform certain tasks or you create an object, you create some physical things. For example, a person wants to construct a house and he makes a plan on the paper basically. So like what is the dimensions of the living room, bedroom, master bedroom, and wash area, etc., kitchen, etc. So once he draw the plan on the paper, then he starts constructing actual house. So the actual house is nothing but object. And we have a plan.
Okay.
So based upon the plan, you can construct as many houses as possible, right?
Right.
So here, building plan or blueprint, we call them. It is nothing but a class. And the objects, you create house one, house two, house three, like that. You construct houses. And classes will have the details such as the dimensions, measurements of the rooms actually, 10 by 14, like that. So that data is there in the plan. So inside the class also, you have the data. And function.
Okay.
You have data and functionality. So class, in brief, in simple terms, class is nothing but a blueprint or a plan. Based upon the plan, you construct the objects.
Mm-hmm.
So they have simplified a lot of things in Python. And Python can be used for rapid application development. This is a software engineering technique. And if you want to design an application, say morning you get the requirements, by afternoon you can design the application.
All right.
Yeah, with such a speed you can design the application. And one more thing, in Java or C++, if you write 100 lines of 100 lines of program for a particular task, for a particular problem, but in Python you can achieve the same thing within less than 10 lines.
All right. Okay. So it's much more something and much more efficient.
Yeah, much more efficient. Yes. It's a compact as well as efficient and robust.
Understood.
And it has elegant syntax and dynamic typing. I just demonstrated what is dynamic typing. Internally, it will adjust. The variables will be adjusted to take different types of data. So first it takes just second, and then after some time it may take string or other floating point numbers, etc. So that characteristic of variables is known as dynamic typing, and you don't have to declare the variable. Straight away you can define the variables. You can start using the variables.
Got it, sir.
Yeah.
Got it.
Yeah. And story.
So this was about objects and classes and about basically a Python story behind the name. I heard it from a comedy show.
So it is like the creator, his name is Gaudio van Rossum. He is from Netherlands actually. He created this programming language way back in 1996 or 95. Mid 90s, he designed this, he created this program, and he was contemplating to give a name to this new programming language. So he was thinking for several days. And then he was watching his favorite show on BBC. The name of the show is, it is a Monty Python's Flying Circus.
Okay.
So he was watching this and suddenly it stuck to him, okay, the new programming language can be named as Python. So he named it Python. So that is the story behind the name. So he's from Netherlands actually, Gaudio van Rossum. But initially, it is a freeware actually. Nobody owns this actually. A group of software engineers, a community of software engineers across the globe, they started adding new features to this programming language actually. So now the latest version is 3.6. And it has been created in year 1996 and 95. But Java is also came into existence in the same year, but the version is around 8th version now. 9th version also released. And Java is owned by Oracle Corporation. But Python, nobody owns it. It is a free software.
It's an open source.
It's an open source. And it is gaining momentum since big data framework came into, that came into picture. Like, so Python, people started using Python, and a lot of features have been added to this Python. So we have like modules, we call them as modules or APIs, application program interfaces, wherein you can design any application. Say, for example, you want to design web servers, you can design using Python. And you want to design database servers, or you want to access the database server and manipulate the data, you throw program, you can do so with Python. Also, you want to do some networking programming, such as, say, in an organization, what will happen, you have several servers are there, and the administrator will be there. And if he wants to find out what server is down, what server is up and running, physically, it is very difficult to verify what server is down and what server is up. So programmatically, he can design a program so that the program will verify what server is down, and it will give a report. So-and-so server at IP address, this is down and this is up and running. So he can investigate further. So you name the application, we can design using Python. We have standard APIs, and around approximately 12,000 APIs are available to date, and still it is going. Every day new features have been added, and you can design any application using Python. Okay. And features of Python, let us see what are the features. It is very simple, and Python is simple and minimalistic language. As I told you that in other programming languages, if you write 100 lines of code, in Python, you can achieve the same with less than 10 lines. Okay. And if you read a good Python program, you feel like reading an English text or English prose. And it looks like a pseudocode. In fact, it doesn't look like a programming thing, and it looks like a pseudocode. And the pseudocode nature is its greatest strength.
Okay.
And because of this pseudocode nature, you can focus on the solution to a problem rather than focusing on language itself. Okay? And it is very simple. And then, so you're saying something? Any questions? Your voice is breaking. One moment.
No, nothing.
Hello.
Nothing.
Hello, your voice is breaking somehow. Could you repeat the question? Hello. 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 Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Ajna. Is there any problem with the network?
Hello.
Hello.
No, sir, there's no issue. I was able to hear you. I think we should try.
Okay.
Reconnect one.
Okay.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yes, I can hear you, sir. Hello, I can hear you.
Yeah, I'm able to hear you. I'm able to hear you. Somehow your voice is breaking, but anyway.
Hello.
Hello, you are able to hear me?
I can hear you, sir.
Okay.
I can hear you.
Okay, if you want to ask a question, you can.
Hello, sir.
Hello, hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, are you able to hear me?
Hello, sir. I can hear you, sir.
Okay, okay. Shall I continue? Hello. One second. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, it is clear now. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, sir.
So, you understand this, right? Very simple. If you want to ask a question, you can put it in a chat window also. You can ask in chat.
Oh, okay. Sure, sir. Sure.
All right. So, and this is Python is extremely easy and simple to learn, start with. And it has extraordinarily simple syntax. If you look at the syntax, it's very simple and it doesn't have much restricted guidelines. So,
okay.
A lot of flexibility in writing programs. So, and it is free and open source. Best part is like you can download the software and you can redistribute the software to your friends and relatives. And you can also look into the source code of this software, Python interpreter. And if you want to make changes, you can make changes to the. So, for example, you take Java. Java is from Oracle, and I cannot read the source code. I can download it freely, but I cannot read it. If I want to add a new feature, I have to request Oracle Corporation to include that feature in the next release.
Correct.
Yeah, but correct. In the case of Python, you can download the software, you can read the source code, and you can make changes to the source code according to your requirement. And you can use it in your programs or in your applications. That is a free and open source thing. And it is an example of FLOSS. So FLOSS is like free, library and open source software. And you don't have to pay any license fee for this.
Okay.
So the advantage is you can redistribute the copies and you can read the source code and you can make changes. So you can play around with the source code as well.
Okay. Got it.
Yeah. And is the concept of community which shares the knowledge, because so we have software engineers across the globe. They work independently and they add new features and they want to see a better Python every day.
Okay. Yes. So got it.
That is reason why Python is very good and it is gaining popularity. Major gains such as Oracle, IBM and Microsoft and other major people, major companies are using and investing in R&D.
Got it.
So it is a high level language, meaning you don't have to worry about low level details. So for example, if you design an application using C program, you have to consider the memory management. You have to allocation of the memory and deallocation of the memory, etc. But whereas in Python, you just simply write the program and execute it. That's it. The low-level details is taken care by the interpreter. Python is an interpreter, basically. Okay? And it has a garbage collector, which flushes out the unused objects that are there in the memory. So, garbage collector is a piece of program that is included in Python. Automatically, it is being executed internally. And it will verify what are the objects that are unused, that are not used for a specific amount of time. And it will be pushed out. And it is portable, meaning if you design application in one environment such as Windows, the same application without changing a single line of code, you can implement in other environments such as Linux or same. So these are some of the portable, like these are some of the areas where you can design the application and use it in other environments such as Linux, Windows, FreeBSD, Macintosh, Solaris, OS2, etc. Okay, I just listed out some of the platforms.
Got it, sir.
Then these are other platforms, and then it is an interpreter, it is not a compiler, meaning if you write a program. And each line is read by the Python interpreter, and the line will be converted to machine language or bytecode, and it is executed immediately. Like that, line by line, it will read. Suppose in a particular line there is a syntax error, and it will stop there. It stops execution there, and it will give that information. So and so line, there is a syntax error, or so and so line, some other error it will display. Okay, so that's
yes. For the
now you understand what is a C language and Java, C++. They are all compilers. So what is
a Achha.
Compiler? What it will do? You design a program. You write a program. You submit it to compiler. It could be C language or Java or anything. Mm-hmm. So for C language, mm-hmm. you use C compilers, and you submit mm-hmm. your program to C compiler, and it will generate mm-hmm. another file. So it generates an executable file.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the case with compiler. Say if it is a Java program, you write a program, Java program, and you use a Java compiler.
Mm-hmm.
And it generates a class file or executable file. I can call it as executable file. Okay. So your program is different. This is known as source code, and this is executable file. So in order to execute the program, you use this executable file. Okay. So that is a thing. So in between, while translating, generating this executable file, say our program consists of some errors. So the errors are syntax errors. Assume that. It will show all the syntax errors. Show all the syntax errors at once, and you fix the error in the program, save it, and again submit to C compiler, and you will generate the executable file. Provided there are no syntax errors. Okay.
Right. Got it, sir. Got it. Yeah.
So, whereas in the case of a compiler, interpreter program, is interpreter, say such as it will read each line from the top, and converts it to machine code or byte code. We call it as byte code, and then immediately executes it. That's it. Then it goes to the next line. It goes to read next line, and that is converted to byte code. That line is converted to byte code and executes it. This way it continues to execute all the lines. Okay, this is the case with the interpreter. So Python is an interpreter. And you don't have to worry about linking the libraries and all that. Automatically, it will be taken care of by the interpreter.
Yes.
And then, so this is all about. And then we have object-oriented. So it supports both procedure-oriented as well as object-oriented. The procedure-oriented,
okay.
You write all the functions, collection of functions. Say you write function one. Each function will perform its task function. And say, and you have some statement function two, and like mm-hmm. that, the collection of functions. That means each program or a problem is divided into smaller problems, and each smaller problem represents a function. So basically, function mm-hmm. performs specific tasks. So like that, we have function one, function three, and you have a number of functions. Okay, like this. So this is in procedure oriented, but whereas in object oriented, you have classes. As I told you, classes are nothing but a blueprint which contains data as well as functionality. What functionality that acts on data and objects. You create an objects based on classes or plan.
Mm-hmm.
So we use different objects and different classes for different purposes. So Python supports both the things, both object-oriented as well as procedure-oriented.
Mm-hmm.
And it is extensible, meaning you write a Python program. Say, for example, I have Python program. And mm-hmm. I have a module, say some module I want to make it run very fast, or I don't want to disclose those details to client or anybody. In that case, I include a C program. C or Java program inside the Python program. For that module, a small function or is written in C language that can be included in Python, and you can execute it.
Okay.
That is known as extensible. And also another feature is embeddable. Embeddable means you are designing applications C++. In that case, you write C program, for example, include a Python program, include Python statements or Python program in C language. So you can embed the in other languages such as C, C++, and Java. So that is also possible with Python. Okay. So this is the thing. And then we have extensive libraries for different tasks, such as regular expressions, unit testing, threading. You can design multi-threading programming and databases for web browsers. I just mentioned some of the things, and you can design any application. You name it. We have standard library for everything. Using standard libraries, we can design the application with ease, without any problem. And does anyone really using Python? There are a lot of organizations, they started using Python. And here I listed out some of the organizations. Industrial Light and Magic, this uses Python to help with image processing and lighting special effects. So they want to process some images that are sent from the satellites. So they process the images and also lighting special effects. For that purpose, they use Python extensively. Hello? You are there?
Hello? Yes, sir. Yeah. I can hear you.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm here.
Yeah. Very good. And there is another company called forecastwatch.com. And this is very popular in USA.
Yeah.
And so they predict weather forecast. So, so they collect the data from the various sources, and they predict whether it will be snowy or rainy or sunny, like that they will predict. So in order to predict, they take the they design the programs with Python. They analyze the lots of data using Python program, and they predict, and the accuracy is very, you know, 100% accuracy. They also predict that, say, 3 inches of snow or something like that. Exactly, it will happen 3 inches or 6 inches. So that is the precision of the forecast. So there is another company called DevNet, which uses Python to aggregate news feeds. So they use Python extensively. And in fact, a student in the UK, he designed a dinosaur on his desktop. What this dinosaur will do, it will roar every time that has been mentioned about the dinosaurs on Twitter. So every time somebody mentions about dinosaur on Twitter, on his desktop, the dinosaur will roar. So he designed such an application using Python. And but let's be clear about something. You will be learning, you won't learn enough in this course to start adding special effects to the next big superhero movies such as Bahubali, etc. But you will be learning enough to start real world problems with the code. You will be definitely designing applications to solve the real problems. Or you can have have fun with the Python program.
Okay? Got it.
So this is all about introduction. And you have any questions? Just let me know.
Subject related, sir, it was quite clear, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. So I just wanted to actually go through the coursework, because I got there was some SciPy and
SciPy,
some
SciPy.
Other
okay SciPy. Okay, SciPy, we call it SciPy. Yes, sir.
SciPy. So we learn about that also, sir? We'll be learning.
So SciPy is for scientific purposes. We have this actually. SciPy is basically designed for scientific applications. So I will open the table of contents, what I am teaching.
So yes, sir.
I have an idea. And So if you want, also I can customize the things. Basically, if any participant wants some additional extra topics, I will include in that. So basically, the course length is 32 hours. And this is the basic core Python, like introduction, history, and all that. Conditional statements, looping statements, control statements, string manipulations, list, tuples, dictionaries, sets, functions, modules, files in Python, how you can process the files, how you can create, how you can close, how you can open. Such things we'll discuss in this chapter.
Okay.
And also exception handling. If some error occurs, how you will handle programmatically. Say, user runs a program and sometimes he gets an error. So how you handle that?
Correct.
And in advanced topics, advanced Python, we'll discuss about OOPs, like classes and objects, how you can create a class and how you can create an object, all those details, inheritance and polymorphism. And we do not have encapsulation in Python. We do have encapsulation, but direct approach is not there. Indirectly, you can implement it. So there are some techniques that is not documented actually. So we can apply those techniques and implement encapsulation. Encapsulation is basically hiding the data. You want to hide certain information so that it is not visible to the other users or outside the class. Then we can hide it. That is the concept is known as encapsulation. So, I designed some programs using encapsulation. I will explain that. So the main important thing is inheritance. Even polymorphism concept, polymorphism is we have a function which will perform based on certain inputs. And if you change the type of inputs, still your function will work. So polymorphism is a thing like poly means many, morph means many, what you call, shapes. Right? So there is an Italian, Greek word, I think, poly, many shapes. So you have a function which performs with a different inputs, different types of inputs. So we have all these things. And then regular expression is an important thing. And we discuss the, all examples. And NumPy is for numerical processing. And this is important. You can create arrays and, you know, all those details we discuss in this NumPy. And Matplotlib, this is for data visualization. Suppose you want to see the data, how it looks like. You want to generate pie chart or histograms or bar charts or any type of charts. You can use this module, this API we can use, Matplotlib. And we discuss here how you can design the graphs using Python program. Similarly, databases. You have a database. Every organization has a database. And how you load the data using Python program. How you can connect to the database and extract the data, etc. And pandas are very powerful in Python. So it is for you. If we have a file, for example, and you want to process the file data, data that is there in the file, we use the pandas, basically.
Okay.
So, for example, you have Excel sheet. So, you want to process the Excel sheet. Pandas is very easy. So, there are so many modules. We call them as modules or APIs available. So, these are the important modules I'm covering. And you said Skype, right? Skype is for scientific applications. I will also give an introduction to Skype. Skype explain the details of Skype.
Okay. Sir, actually, you know, I was in conversation with some other tutors as well, I found one content very intriguing. Can I share content list with you?
Sure, definitely.
So I'll mail it to you right now.
Yeah.
And you know, if we can imbibe that, because I like the way, you know, I liked your approach, sir. To be very frank.
Okay.
Yeah. So. Yeah, sir. So
we'll, can go we'll, yeah, we will take that what you have with you, that table of contents, then we can implement the same thing.
Definitely. How much will it be costing, sir?
So initially I told you that 15K, but I will give you concession, right? 1,000 rupees concession. So
1,000. Actually, you know, yesterday only I was speaking with them, and the one I got the table of contents from.
Okay.
And he was charging me 10,000. So today, actually, I was to make
payment to him.
Okay.
But yeah, but you know, I found your approach nice, and I want to continue. So if you know, we can. And that was also actually my budget, like I mentioned to you in the start as well.
Okay.
Like when we were having a conversation, yeah, sir. So she can have some discount.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. How much you want discount? How much you want to pay?
We'll make it to the same price, no, sir. Like even he was taking. Yes, sir. Because it's only Python, no, sir. And.
And I also include. Also, but okay, no problem. You can share your.
Yeah, sir.
Contents.
I'll do it.
Okay.
Definitely. So, also, sir, 32 hours will be enough because he was taking. Around 90 hours of class.
So let me see the table of contents and so
definitely, sir.
Yeah, yeah. So 30 is sufficient to learn. You can practice. I will give you the exercises and quizzes. I will give
okay,
you
okay, sir.
So that you can practice.
I will be proficient, no, sir. I will be proficient, right?
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
at the end of the course, you can start designing the applications.
Perfect, sir.
And perfect. I will also give a small project, which I did actually. It's a real-time project for a company in Hong Kong. So I will give the project, and you can, you know, experiment with that, and you can understand that.
Definitely, sir. Yeah. That'll be wonderful. Yeah. So I'll send over to you the details.
Yeah.
And then you know, we can work out something.
Okay, sure.
Perfect,
sure. Sir. So from when can we start?
Today evening. If it all works out.
Yeah, actually the thing is my brother's daughter's marriage is scheduled on 3rd of March.
All right, sir. So okay,
I will be busy in these 3 days actually.
Okay, sir, not an issue. After that we can start.
So can we start from 5th of March, Monday?
Okay, sir, Monday we can start.
Okay, what time is the convenient time for you, in the morning or evening?
Morning, what time, sir?
Morning is 10 o'clock is okay, or you are busy?
10 o'clock is fine. So 10 o'clock is fine.
So we'll make it 10 o'clock every day.
We'll make it 10 o'clock, sir. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Then okay. I will send you the link, new link to you. So then we can start fifth onwards. So meanwhile, you can see the table of contents.
Yeah.
I will see.
Definitely.
Is there any extra things? We'll also cover that based upon the deals. Okay.
Yes, sir. So some parts of machine learning, an introduction to machine learning, and you know, some other things are also there.
Okay.
So that's all. Yeah. So I'll just share that with you, sir. Okay. And then you get back to me.
Right. Right.
Perfect.
All right. You have any other questions?
Pardon?
You have any other questions?
No, sir. That's it.
Okay,
that's
then. It. Sir. All right. All right.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you,
sir.
Thank you. And we'll see you on Monday. Okay. Yeah.
Perfect. Definitely. Yeah. Sir.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Yes. Have a great day, sir.
You too. You too. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.